Heroin. There may be no other opioid that has elicited so much attention or has embedded itself so thoroughly into Western culture. Heroin chic was all the rage in the 90s, and with bands like U2 and Guns N' Roses writing songs about heroin addiction. Even the fashion industry pushed the drug-inspired pale skin, dark under-eye circle look. But heroin is not just an American or European story. Its roots go back thousands of years to ancient Mesopotamia, where opium poppies were first cultivated. Opium use became rampant in China in the 7th century, and by the late Middle Ages, opium trade grew along popular trade routes called the Silk Roads, which extended all the way from China to Western and Northern Europe. Heroin was first synthesized from morphine in Germany in 1874 by the Bayer Company, but physicians were initially unaware of its addictive properties. Within just a couple of decades, heroin's use reached such critical levels that by 1924, it was outlawed in the U.S. Today, much of the U.S. heroin supply is processed in South America and sold illegally as a white or brownish powder. Surprisingly, it can also be purchased on the internet. Its usage in the U.S. has been on the rise since 2007, with close to 1 million users today. This trend appears to be driven mainly by young adults between 18 to 25 years old. Of course, with more use comes more addiction and more deaths. In 2018, nearly 15,000 people died from a drug overdose involving heroin in the United States, a rate of almost 5 deaths for every 100,000 Americans. Heroin is often injected, but can also be snorted or smoked. Soon after consumption, the user may experience positive feelings, such as euphoria, intense pleasure, and reduction of pain. However, a user may quickly develop a dependency and starts to experience withdrawals when not using the drug. Heroin withdrawals usually begin 6 to 24 hours after the last dose. Withdrawal symptoms can be severe and vary by person. Some factors that affect heroin withdrawal include duration of use, dosage, and how the drug was used. Symptoms of heroin withdrawal can vary from mild, moderate, to severe. They can be very unpleasant and even dangerous. Within 2 to 4 days, these symptoms will peak before subsiding. Even after the end of the withdrawal process, which can last up to 1 month, it is estimated that up to 90% of opioid users will suffer from post-acute withdrawal syndrome, which can last up to a year. There are three popular treatments often offered to patients struggling with heroin addiction. The first is a form of medication-assisted treatment, with replacement opioids like methadone and Suboxone. These substitutes mask the withdrawals and can be used to taper down the dosages of heroin. But rather than treating your opioid dependency, you are just replacing one opioid with another opioid. Worse than that, those replacements can easily cause even more serious dependency, along with stronger withdrawals. The second option includes either staying in a long-term rehab center, a detox facility, or any other related therapy, which includes methods such as support groups or a 12-step program. In these care facilities, the primary goal is to help the addict with the symptoms, instead of treating the lifelong dependency. It's not surprising why 70 to 80% of the participants relapse within a few months after treatment. The third option is to undergo rapid detox, where the goal is to treat the withdrawal and not the root of the dependency, making this treatment ineffective in the long run. Ultimately, heroin addiction should be treated at its biological root, the brain. With the A&R treatment, we can evaluate each individual and restore their own neurological and chemical balance to a pre-dependency state, effectively eliminating their withdrawals and cravings, defeating the heroin dependency from the root.